My name is John Riddle.
I am Angel Azula.
I'm a senior art major, and I'm from Borger, Texas.
I'm an art and education major, and I'm currently a junior. And I'm from Plainview, Texas.
After I graduate, I'd like to get a job in either illustration or design.
After I graduate, I plan on going into the education field and hopefully teach art. My favorite media has always been pen and ink, but right now I'm really into watercolor.
I recently became interested in digital art because I found that there are things you can do digitally that are impractical or very difficult to do with traditional physical medias. And I found I can still work in a very large format while working on my computer. I find myself inspired by artists of the past, people like Andy Warhol or Jasper Johns, but lately I've found most of my inspiration coming from just things that I see in my head and that I want to exist, and therefore I have to create them.
Usually when I come up with something, it's usually just like an idea that I have. So I start with almost like a basis. I really never know what a finished piece is going to look like until it's finished. It just kind of evolves as I'm doing it.
Most of my art pieces start in either one of two ways. They either start from I have a medium that I want to work in or something I want to use to make art with that may or may not be conventional, and I have to work a concept around the idea that I want to work in that medium. And then other pieces come from the idea that I have something in my head that I want to create, and I just have to simply choose the media that I want to work in. Over the past two summers, I've been working on restoration work on large-scale murals in Hale Center. And last summer, Angel and I restored five different murals. Most of these murals were almost 15 years old and required a lot of work in order to restore them. In some cases, when we would begin working, we'd actually find that bits of the wall would begin to come off, and on one mural in particular, we had large portions of stucco that had to be completely repainted. For Angel and I, to work on these murals was a great privilege because we were able to do something for our community.
These by far were the largest scale of art that I've ever worked on. The sheer volume and the amount of murals we worked on, it was pretty time consuming, but I had a lot of fun doing it, and you know, I learned a lot of things along the way. John and I received a lot of support from the people from Hale Center. They were really glad to see that we were taking the time to restore these original works. My ideas are suggestions people have given to me, or things that I have just wanted to try, things that have always interested me. I see art and I want to try to reproduce it, and I want to try to figure out how that artist did it, so I try it. My personal opinion is people see art majors and they think we're lazy, or you know, we do things on a whim, and they don't realize when we're planning something out, there's a lot to it. Somebody sits you in front of a canvas and tells you, you know, paint. You're stumped for a second because you don't know what to paint. And once you start the process, it is a lot of trial and error, and you're constantly correcting things and going back and shading this area and fixing this area and then erasing it out and starting over. And it's really not all that easy. I mean, there's a long process to creating any image that, you know, any watercolor, any drawing.
it just doesn't come really fast for an art major, or for me. There's always a long process into creating anything that I do.
The thing about art majors is we're left to our own devices in most cases. We have free rein to do what it is that we want in order to create something interesting, but that's also to say we're also expected to create something interesting. So where some will take this opportunity and not do anything with it and simply just create because they have to, others will find the opportunity to create and they'll thrive in that opportunity, and that's what makes the more interesting pieces of the people who are willing to commit more of their time in order to being a good artist. Recently, I've been working on a series I've called the Dying Sun series, which is an interesting developmental process for me to go through, because I came up with the idea of creating a world and completely fleshing out the art style and the different aspects of what makes this world seem cohesive, and try to use those elements in multiple different pieces to kind of show something that could even be considered somewhat of a story.
I have a series of pictures that have a military theme to them. I have a brother who's in the military. I have an uncle who's in the military. I have military in the family. So, you know, this stuff is always on my mind. So I create pictures of things that I'm thinking about at any given moment. So you can see that a lot in my art.
As an artist, one of the most important things that I do is exhibit my pieces at different shows. In this case, I'm preparing for my senior art show. And this can be a very long process. Some of the things that have to be taken into account is where you're going to be hanging your pieces and in what arrangement, on what wall. How are you going to be changing the lighting in order to best show your pieces? And these are things that have to be taken into account just so that your pieces are ready to be viewed.
Hanging pictures or doing an exhibition, that's a whole beast in itself. It's a long process. You take a picture down, you put one up, you switch it. There's lighting is involved. There's just a lot going on. This is probably my least favorite part of art. For me, art is the ultimate way I can express myself. I can't think of any other way to express myself fully than with pen and ink or watercolor and paper.
Art is everything. I mean, it's everything to me, and it's everything to everyone else. Because when you really think about it, everything you see has been created by an artist, whether for form or function. While the art that I work on is meant to be viewed on a wall at some place, some art that's created by other artists is just things that you use every day. The bottle you drink water out of, the phone you use every day, those things were created for function. But the things that I create are just for form. And that's really what it comes down to, is everything is art. And in that way, maybe nothing is art.